Local Memphis Live continues with your host, Amy Spiropoulos.
Oh, if I just had a dime for how many times I've said my kids don't listen, I would be a rich woman, and I bet you can say the same. But the truth is, we can make our kids listen without being a helicopter mom and an intrusive parent. Yes, it is possible. I know I see you at home going, what? Help me, help me. Join us now to walk through the how of this. Welcome, Dr. Marcia Beagle.
Yes.
Beagle.
Hi.
See, I'm so excited about what you're about to tell us. I'm like, just tell me.
No, it's so good.
I love it. Welcome, by the way.
Thank you. I'm so thrilled to be here.
Well, you know, it's wonderful. We are thrilled to have you. It's wonderful. Before we came out, we were talking about having kids. You know, no one gives you a rule book. No one tells you how to do it. And wonderful, Dr. Beagle said, but I wrote the book. And I'm like, what? It doesn't take me 4 hours to get through it.
No.
Tell me.
And actually, My Kids Don't Listen, which is a book that I just wrote for you, is free today
at
mykidsdontlisten.com.
That's
presents
amazing.
For everybody.
So it's free.
It's free.
Presents. It's like watching
free.
The Ellen Show. You get free things and you can watch us. It's
exactly.
Great.
Exactly. So go to mykidsdontlisten.com, put in your email address, and it gets sent right to you.
So tell us about this.
Okay. So I get asked this question so much. It's the number one thing parents talk to me about.
Right.
Which is why I wrote the book.
Absolutely.
So here's the deal. It's not your fault.
Oh my gosh, thank
you. It's your kids.
Hello. Is
right?
that beautiful?
You ask them to put on their shoes, and all of a sudden, you're on the aisle of the lost Lego before you even know what happened.
Oh my gosh.
Right? Right.
I was just saying, Anna's a mom who I had on the beginning of the show. She said, I tell my kids to throw things in the garbage can, and they throw it right next to the garbage can.
Right.
Are you kidding me?
Mm-hmm. So here's what you do. Stick to your message.
Okay.
So if you say, go put on your shoes, then that's all you say until it's done.
Okay, so don't
it
say
becomes,
anything else.
After you put on your shoes, I will help you find your lost Lego.
Wow.
After you put on your shoes, I will help you give me as many hugs and kisses as you want, because that's their favorite distractor.
It is.
You need to run the show.
I
know that you're
going to be my friend. I just said this to my kids the other day in the car. I was like, girls, they're six, seven, and 11. I said, you are not the leader. I'm the mommy.
Yep.
And I'm sitting here and I'm like, but be the mommy.
Right. You have to be the mommy. And that's one of the hardest things
yeah,
to do.
It is.
Which is why My Kids Don't Listen is a bunch of do's and don'ts.
Yes. And it's interesting because I often throw my kids, I'm like, go get your shoes, get this. So it's no wonder they forget.
Yes.
So what else?
Yes. So my favorite, which is on page two because it's that important, is do not beg your kids. Do tell them what's going to happen and follow through.
That's very simple.
So instead of, come on, you have to eat your dinner. Don't you want your peas? It's so good for you. You're going to be healthy. Don't you want dessert? Just say, if you eat dinner, then you get dessert. Then have a lovely meal.
Wow.
If they eat dinner, they get dessert. If not, they don't.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that amazing?
It is.
And you know, you've been doing this for a really long time, so these are lessons that you have learned firsthand.
Uh-huh. I've been doing it for 20 years.
Wow.
And for me, it's all about what is practical, doable, and actionable.
Absolutely.
Right? So my other favorite do and don't, ready?
Tell me.
Is do not multitask. Do one thing at a time.
Wow.
So instead of getting your kids dressed, while you're getting yourself dressed, while you're brushing your teeth, while you're making dinner, do get your kids dressed. Then get yourself dressed, then make lunch, because it will save you time and frustration, which every parent needs.
Oh my gosh, are you reading my mind? Dr. Beagle, I mean, last night I'm doing this, and in the meantime, I'm yelling at my husband, and I'm like, why are you not helping me? And I'm yelling at Ashlyn, and I'm like, why are you not getting your nightgown on and brushing your teeth?
Right, so the biggest thing that I teach in my workshops around the yelling is that you have to start having fun with your kids.
That's awesome.
So I will teach parents how to juggle. So when you're doing laundry, you take a few socks, throw them in the air and do a show for your kids. 30 seconds, done.
You make it fun.
You make it fun. Or you do a happy dance. Like this.
Oh.
Happy, happy, happy dance. You came to dinner. You are amazing.
Oh my gosh, I can totally do that.
And it takes 10 seconds.
I love it.
And all of a sudden they'll listen because they don't know what else you're going to do next.
Right.
They're always watching
What's
me
going
too.
On? I love this.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Oh, okay, so what do we do to get your it's free.
It's free. Yeah.
My kids
don't listen.com.
My kids don't listen.com. My kids don't listen.com. You can get it now.
For free.
I love it. Girl, yeah. You are amazing.
Thank you. Oh my gosh,
she is so fabulous. Go get it right now, and trust me, you will have less fighting, less yelling, and a more happy home with all of your kids. And you might even be saying, namaste.
That'd be great.
Wouldn't that be wonderful?
Uh-huh. We can get that in there.
I love it. Thank you so much, Doctor, for joining us. Stick around. More Local Memphis Live is up after the break. Get your book now. MyKidsDon'tListen.com. MyKidsDon'tListen.com. But you keep listening, because Local Memphis Live continues after the break. That was awesome, girl.